The life of a peasant is also very dependent of the policies that are concerning agriculture. And as a young farmer, you will be maybe curious to know, how shall I be supported if I want to start a farm? What sort of support can I get both from my country and also from Europe? As you know, Europe has developed a policy over the years. It is a common agricultural policy, where some measures are especially concern young farmers. You have in terms of young farmer scheme, you have a support, a grant that can be given in some countries to young farmers as a amount of money at the beginning of your work. And you have also some subsidies that are given per hectare, like some other subsidies that are given to all farmers. But as a young farmer, you will have a top up. But the question is, where do these policy come from? How, as a young farmer, you can you benefit from those? But also, how can you help? How can you contribute to change them? As you see that they are not always supportive to the type of farming that you want to promote. So this is why it is important to know how it functions, how the decisions are taken at European level. Mostly what we call in Brussels, in the Brussels bubble, where there will be discussion between the European Commission, which is in charge of driving the policy for Europe for 5 years, and which changes every 5 years. And then you have this discussion with the European Commission that makes proposals. Then you have the countries that further discuss on the proposal, and also the members of parliament, who will decide together with the countries on the different policies. So concerning farming, maybe you're familiar with the CAP, but it's also possible to go deeper into it and see what's on the plate for the future reform. Because as you know, there are very often reform of the CAP, and the last one took place in the between 2010 and 2013 for the CAP 14-20 that we know, that we are now depending on. But now for the next period, there are discussions for a new CAP. There has been proposal put on the table in 2018. Then we changed the members of parliament last year, and so now they started again to discuss on the proposal and on the content of the proposal. But in the meantime, we changed the European Commission, and this new European Commission, whose president is Mrs. von der Leyen, has put some interesting projects on the table. Like you may know, the European Commission has put four, six priorities on the table. One of them is the Green New Deal. It's a new deal that's aiming at having a carbon neutral Europe by 2050. It's quite ambitious, and it is going to influence many different policies in Europe, and especially the question of food. Concerning food, there is a part of the Green Deal which is called the Farm to Fork Strategy, and it concerns specifically the food systems, how to make them more sustainable. And there is a strong and quite ambitious part on the reduction of pesticides and reduction of fertilizers, but also different concerns to improve the CAP in order to make it to improve food policies in order to make them more sustainable in the coming years. It also relates to the CAP in that sense that it is clearly stated that there should be a good relationship between the CAP and the Farm to Fork strategy. So that makes some opportunity for the future for young farmers to be more taken into consideration, because they represent the future. You represent a possible change in the way we farm, in the way we produce food, in the way food chains are organized. And this is what we can discuss further and see how, as young farmer, you can influence the coming policies. That's a great challenge.